Hey, it's Matt and Lizzie in the morning. And did you realize that people can listen to us anytime they want?
They can?
Nonstop if they wanted to.
No.
Yeah, it's Matt and Lizzie on demand. And it starts right now.
In his place. And you know, it's a hard thing to do, but I will take that job just so that you can get the best from both of us.
Oh my God. The community work you're doing.
How's that?
Ooh.
Oh, I think I'm doing a lot. I think I should get an award for dealing with some stuff.
A Nobel or a Pulitzer.
Both.
For sure.
But it depends on what day. Normally Tuesdays, normally earlier on the week, it's more work. By the end of the week, we're, you know, excited, you know, the weekend's coming, but yeah. You know, that's what I have to deal with.
Am I like the project boyfriend you always wanted?
No, because I would never take on a project boyfriend.
Yeah, well, you took on me. I'm a project.
You took on me.
Yeah, you're a project.
Yeah.
92 Moose, Central Maine's number one hit music station. Good morning.
Good morning.
Matt and Lizzie, 6:54 now. Coming up at 7:20, playing Fact or Crap with Lizzie.
Ooh.
Your chance to win tickets to see Post Malone coming up this September. You don't want to miss our game this morning.
Jimmy.
Time now for Lizzie's Daily On.
Oh, I miss Jimmy so much. Tickling those ivories. I got a good one for you guys. Grab the tissues. This all happened in Italy. And it's pretty heart-wrenching, but let me explain everything to you beginning to end. In the city of Fasano, a 25-year-old woman named Celia Detano went to leave her apartment just like any other day. She lived on the fourth floor of this building, and when she went to get into the elevator, she stepped down, but her feet never found the ground. She fell four stories to her death. Due to a malfunctioning elevator. The elevator wasn't even there.
So the door's open to let you in.
The door's open. She stepped in and she fell and she died. Her parents, Giuseppe and I think her name is Juicy, were overwhelmed with grief. And of course, funeral expenses. Enter Steven. Very random. Young man from Milan. He works as a maintenance guy. Dreams of becoming a tattoo artist and a street performer. Steven has never met Celia, but her death, as he saw in the papers, reminded him of his sister Kimberly, who had also died unexpectedly at 19 years old. Steven's heart was telling him to help. And for some reason, this young woman had many similarities to his sister Kimberly. Steven was so moved that he generously contributed to the funeral. So he helped pay for the entire funeral. And he's a maintenance man, guys. He said, I heard and saw her parents sunken in pain, and I immediately felt I had to help. I did that which my heart told me to do. Steven's selfless act is a reminder for all of us about compassion. And in my opinion, by helping Celia's family, he was able to continue to honor his own sissy, Kimberly. And there you go, my darlings. That is your Daily All.
92 Moose.
Here's what's trending
on Pop Crush Night.
Hey, it's Danny with your Pop Crush Poppin'. Justin Timberlake's mugshot is now an art piece in the Hamptons Gallery following his DWI arrest. It is some pop art, and I'm sure we'll be getting it very soon. And fans of Love Island, USA, we still have a hideaway. Where is it? The hideaway. I want to see this footage. Give it to me. For all the latest in pop culture, go to popcrush.com. And tonight, 7 p.m., Pop Crush Night.
92.
Or crap, and then you will agree or disagree with Lizzie's assertion. All right, and you have to get three correct.
Okay.
All right, Candy, here we go. Post Malone's real name is Austin Richard Post.
Fact.
Okay, fact.
Do you agree or disagree with Lizzie?
He said fact.
I disagree.
You disagree?
Oh,
no, his real... Okay, do you agree with her that it's a fact or disagree that it's a fact?
Okay, I think it's a fact.
You think it's a fact? Okay, this is going very well so far. Candy, you get one right. His name is Austin Richard Post.
Yes.
Okay. All right, here we go. Post Malone was born July 4th, 1996.
Crap.
Lizzie says crap.
Crap.
Do you agree that it's crap?
Yeah, I agree. It's crap.
It is crap. He was born in 1995 on July 4th.
Wow.
That's two right there for you, Candy.
We're doing good, Candy. One more.
All right, let's see here. Post Malone got his big break signing a record deal after a song he released called White Iverson.
Fact.
Fact.
That is,
agree with that.
You're going to agree with her, and that is right. That's three for three. Yay! Right there, Tanny. There we go.
Yeah, we did it.
Woo.
You're the best.
All right.
I know I am. So are you.
Candy, you're going to see Post Malone this September in Bangor. What station's making you a winner?
Well, 92 was even way back when your dad was there.
Oh, yes.
That's right.
Rest his soul. I mean, he's still alive, but he's just, he's resting his soul. He's resting his soul. He's not dead. Oh, my word. Thank you so much, Candy, for playing with us this morning. Your next chance to score tickets to see Post Malone. Coming up on Thursday, yep. Thursday morning.
Mark it in your calendar.
And we will be playing Lizzie Can't Lose on Thursday, so get ready for that. Post Malone's breakthrough hit, it's White Iverson.
Number one hit music station, 92.3.
I always forget.
This is a stutter stop.
When I'm supposed to stop talking. Really quickly, getting into 92 Moose tweets of the day. Give us the 30-second Central Maine Idol recap.
Oh, my gosh, it was so cool. The duets were fantastic. It is very hard for the judges at this point. There were 8 people last night, and now it's down to 6, I believe. So good luck. I'll be there next week, 5:30. We kick off in Hollowell, the Quarry Tap Room, for season 4 of Central Maine Idol, and we're narrowing it down. Top 3 will be no time from now, so.
Super excited.
Last night, we bid at a judge's seat for $500.
Amazing. Yes. Who's the auctioneer that did that?
I did.
Oh, good for you. Central Maine Idol returns to Hollowell next Monday night at 5:30. Time now for the 92 Moose Tweets of the Day, powered by Burano's Wood-Fired Pizza, buranospizza.com. They've got the first bite guarantee. Let's see what's trending on Twitter this morning. This is from T-Bone7219. Is it okay to savagely beat your coworker with an office chair when they say Happy Monday? I say yes. I say yes, it is.
No one would dare say that in this room.
Every single person listening to this show right now across the globe will relate with this tweet.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah.
Even our, we have a lot of listeners, believe it or not, in North Carolina, Nevada, and Florida.
We do.
So
we
good
do.
Morning. Good morning, states away. Sorry about the heat. Everyone relates to this. This is from Erica next door. Sorry I left you on red. I didn't mean to open it. Okay. You ever do that? You're like, damn it.
100%.
This is from it just being Emma. I've got big plans tonight. I'm going to sit down in one room until it's time to go lie down in another.
Ooh. Yeah, baby. That's heaven right there.
I relate to this. This is literally my marriage. This is from Matt O'Brien.
Uh-huh.
Marriage is sneezing 3 times in a row and then hearing someone in the next room yell, oh my God!
Yeah, stop.
This is from it Blonde Hot Coffee. 20K in my bank account, but the K is silent.
Yeah, for now. For now.
This is from it, Rin Lee. Might start booing people during conversations I'm not interested in. I have so many good ones today. I'm just going to do all of them. This is from it, Not Today, Eric. Sorry I'm late. The grocery store was playing bangers. This is from it, Andy Van Slyke. Sorry I'm late. I was frantically applying to other jobs. This one is just sent up. This is a sweet tweet from
sweet
Bob
tweet.
Golan. Sometimes memories leak out of my eyes and roll down my cheeks.
Oh,
very sweet. We'll give you this as your bonus tweet today. This is from Simon Holland. My neighbors with the fireworks would like to wish everyone a happy 9th of July. There you go. It's the 92 Moose tweet.
Okay.
And nobody was hurt.
Right.
Because oftentimes.
And there's a video of it.
There is a video. Yeah, the AP has a video. Now, in my story all the way at the bottom, you'll see a link right to it.
Crazy.
And you can watch the video. But congratulations to Brady Procon for jumping into action at only 17 years old.
I love that.
On this edition of Not All Heroes Wear Capes, a segment that we may not ever do again. I don't know. 90.